The upper respiratory tract and windpipe are covered in a viscous, slippery substance called mucus. This keeps the air passages moist. It also stops harmful substances from reaching the lungs. Mucus is assisted by the cilia. Each one of these is a mobile propellant and carries the mucus with the foreign bodies stuck in it to the pharynx. Here they are swallowed together with the foreign bodies as a result of the swallowing reflex and are then destroyed by the stomach acid. Alternatively, these foreign bodies may be expelled by coughing. A violent cough can reach speeds of up to 960 kilometers or 600 miles an hour. This is one of the pieces of evidence that serious precautions have been taken to protect the respiratory system. There is another point here that needs to be considered. The cilia in the nasal passage carry the mucus upward. The cilia in the upper respiratory tract, on the other hand, move in a downward direction. In both regions, foreign bodies are carried towards the pharynx. The billions of cilia in both different regions literally know where the pharynx lies. Close inspection reveals a most important miracle here. Cilia are minute structures with no ears, eyes, or brain. So how is it that these blind, deaf structures know the location of the pharynx? All the billions of cilia move together in the same direction. Who teaches the cilia that they all need to move as one in the same direction? Let us consider just one of these cilia. It is a living thing. Ever since it came into the world and throughout its life, it has just one function. It performs that one function without rest or protest. It carries the mucus layer to the pharynx. It is Almighty God who has created man in the finest form who gives them this duty. These miraculous structures perform the function God has given them and work day and night to protect your lungs from foreign bodies. Close examination of the structure of the cilia makes the scale of the miracle even clearer. Under the microscope, the cilia resemble simple tiny hairs, but they are actually a marvel of design and engineering. And they possess a complexity that those circles who defend the theory of evolution can never hope to explain. 9 different protein chains have been brought together in such a way as to form a cylinder. The 2 protein chains in the middle are the system's central motion generator. The proteins dynein and nexine, set out among the protein chains, represent the engines necessary for movement. Thanks to this complex system, which scientists have still to fully reveal, the cilia move at the high speed of 20 beats a second. The design in the cilia cannot be accounted for in terms of evolution, because the system only works if all its components are fully present. It is impossible for it to have developed in stages. In other words, for it to have evolved. There is another point which should not be forgotten. Cilia serve no purpose on their own. They need to work together with the mucus layer in order to protect human life and prevent the entry of foreign bodies. Mucus also turns out to be a marvel of design when examined up close. The mucus layer is rather thin. On the screen you can see a 30 centimeter ruler. Now let us have a look at a 1 millimeter length of that ruler. Now let us divide that 1 millimeter part into 600. 1/600th of a millimeter is so small a number that one cannot imagine it. That is the thickness of the mucus layer which protects your health, 1/600th of a millimeter. Moreover, this thin layer consists of two separate sublayers. The bottom one is rather slippery. This enables the cilia to carry the mucus in a particular direction. The top layer, in other words the safety layer, is rather viscous, which allows it to trap harmful bodies. These two layers never get mixed up or change places. In order to better understand the perfection of the design in the system, let us imagine for a moment that the layers did change place. If the viscous layer were at the bottom, then the cilia would be unable to move and would stick where they were. If the slippery layer were on top, then dust and bacteria could easily reach the lungs without being caught by the mucus. In either event, the system would serve no purpose, and human beings would catch diseases which eventually resulted in their deaths. This system has been functioning flawlessly since the first human beings came into existence. Darwinists claim that this system came into being by chance, stage by stage. Yet that is impossible. As we have just seen, the slightest irregularity or deficiency in the system would cause it to serve no purpose. This is an important piece of evidence invalidating Darwinism. The cilia, which serve you day and night, the mucal secretion with its own very special design, and the aerodynamic design inside the nose all go to prove one very important truth. God created you. The artistry and design evident in every part of your body are proofs of the might of God. In one verse, he states, "We created you, so why do you not confirm the truth?"
Mucociliary clearance is an important part of our respiratory defense mechanism. This mucus transport system clears foreign particles and bacteria from the airways. Over the next 20 minutes, we will see, in video recorded by Dr. Stanislav Totkov, how this important mechanism is affected by temperature and humidity. But let's begin by reviewing where mucus clearance fits into the human respiratory system. Every day we breathe in more than 15,000 liters of air, enough to fill around 1,600 balloons. Even in the most pristine environments, that air is not clean and pure. We inhale thousands of dust, smoke, and virus particles, about 100 bacteria alone every minute. More than 150,000 contaminants each day that, if given free rein, can infect and clog the respiratory system. These foreign particles, viruses and bacteria, are trapped in an extremely sticky mucus layer lining the airways. Mucus carries the trapped material into the larynx in a process known as mucociliary clearance. The physiology of this clearance process isn't completely understood yet, research continues, but let's take a close look at what we do know. We know that mucus transport to clear foreign particles is driven by motile cilia. Cilia are small tentacle-like structures with a diameter about 1,000 times smaller than a human hair, which beat in an asymmetric rhythm. Cilia protrude from most of the epithelial cells lining the airways, densely carpeting the respiratory tract. This was revealed by scanning electron microscope images. Size is indicated by this scale. The cilia are bathed in a watery fluid. The mucus layer, which traps debris, floats on top of this periciliary fluid, and as the cilia beat synchronously, the mucus layer moves.